fans allowed into the Spectrum tonight. Logan, Utah, 44-29. Utah State a lead on Colorado State. Welcome back, Dave, alongside the coach, Bob Wentzel. Utah State looking for their 11th straight win, and it looks like they'll get there thanks to great play down low from Namias Keita again.
Both sides, huh? Yeah. Offense and defense, and their defense has been spectacular as well as a team. But Keita is the name to know, and he's been fantastic in this game right from the very beginning. Inside, catch and score. Inside, repetitive jumping on the offensive glass and uses his size to advantage. Nice movement. And how about the left? I love that. Both left and right hand jump shot. The D has been very, very good. Block shots is one thing, but also they have been all over the floor with loose balls, pushing the ball down the floor, helping each other out, rotating to the ball, causing turnovers. Team effort on the part of the Aggies. Very, very, very interesting stuff. And here are the stats for the game. Conspicuously absent in the area where we have the individuals, Thistlewood has 7 points. The two best players on the team for Colorado State are Roddy and Stevens. They are 1 for 10 from the field with 3 points combined. They average 31 per game. That is the most important thing that has happened in the first half.
Two-time defending Mountain West Tournament champion Aggies have won 17 of 18 in the league play, 20 of 22 at home here in Logan, playing great again here tonight, head-to-head with Colorado State. First two games over 3 days, and up 15 beginning half number two.
Well, they're going to be up 30 at the end of this game if they don't get Roddy and Stevens involved in the offense. I don't think the other guys can really pick it up. Moore obviously can be a threat, number three. But Thistlewood's a stand-up shooter, and they're not going to get a bunch of looks.
Stevens, two-man game with Moores off of who? Morris, turnover.
You know, what's happening right now is when Nico is unhappy about that call. What's happening when Stevens comes off on the ball screen, they are double-teaming him, forcing him to pass the ball. And as a result, he's making passes, but it's not leading to baskets.
Wooster, two-time Montana State High School Player of the Year. A freshman for Utah State, helping run the show in the backcourt. Miller had a great first half. Keita from the elbow for two.
Oh, man. Dave, what does this guy not do? I mean...
I'm looking, Coach. I don't know.
You talk about top big guys in the country, and there's many of them. You know, Luca Garza, obviously, is the name that comes to mind. And there's a bunch of big guys, but I'll tell you what, I mean, in terms of versatility and doing all kinds of things for his team, he is right up there.
Look at this defense in the half court for Utah State. They are digging in again. 8 to shoot. Stevens contested this time, he drains.
Nice shot, Isaiah. Welcome to the game. I'm happy for you. You got to do something in the second half or your team is going to go down here. And he is a wonderful, wonderful player. And he kept his cool in the first half, even though he was defended well. Good D by Moore here. 3-on-2 situation.
Overplay.
Nice pump fake.
3-on-2.
Nicely done.
Deep three for Moore. So back-to-back threes hit for Colorado State. Getting back in the game.
Well, those are the two best three-point shooters in the league percentage-wise. And that is a great, great start for them. Nice coaching by Nico Medved.
Bean, baseline for two.
He's the best guy in this team moving without the basketball. I mean, he just keeps moving and moving and moving, and finally he gets open. He is a wonderful complement to Keita.
Stevens left the lane, hits.
Notice how that screen was a little bit closer in. It was not out by the three-point line. Closer in toward the elbow, so when he comes off of it, he's got a shorter shot. So he's got 5 points in the last 10 seconds.
Ram guards, great start second half here for Nico Medved.
Very, very good.
Wooster crossing over on Thistlewood, gets a run.
That is a strong dude. You mentioned that he played football in Missoula, Montana as well. I mean, he, for a freshman, is really strong. Now, coming into the game, he had 39 assists, but he also had 39 turnovers, and that's to be expected from a guy who's playing his first games in Division I.
Not this time. Long-range shot for Moore. Rebound for Bean. Anthony on the bounce. Kato. Double team foul.
You can tell from the way I've been talking that Isaiah Stevens is one of my favorite players in this conference. And right here, off the dribble, the screen is set, and Kato does not come out. So when you're late on him, he's going to make it. Kato goes down the middle of the lane, and that's a two. He's also made a three right here, right off the bat. And his partner, Kendall Moore, has also made a three. But now they got to dig in at the other end as well.
13 for Kato. And seven rebounds tonight.
2 6-foot guards. There's Moore. 2 6-foot guards. That's short. So those guys have to compensate for their lack of size with quickness and shooting ability, and typically they do that. Marco Anthony on Stevens.
Stevens fires to Kendall Moore. Roddy trying to get involved. Take four. A foul, looking for two, instead earns a trip to the free throw line. They'll shoot a couple here for Colorado State.
Roddy's nature is to take it to the basket. You know, he does shoot some threes. And then when a center is guarding him, he can take guys away from the basket and make some threes. But his nature, he loves the physicality of the game. You could see it on that play where he just took it hard to the hoop.
Four double-doubles this year for him, coach, out of his six career double-doubles. 17 points, 14 rebounds. One of the two games in Phoenix over San Jose State, the sweep of the Spartans recently. He has got to be a factor in the second half of Colorado State's thinking about a comeback.
He had 17 and 14 in that game. So Roddy and Stevens on the scoreboard early in the second half. They've done way more in this few minutes than they did in the entire first half.
Keep in mind, the Rams know about comebacks. They have set a Mount West record this year, down 26 at San Diego State at Rally won the game. Kato, the touch, blocked by Roddy this time. He timed that rejection perfectly.
Utah State got back quickly.
Here's Moore thinking three ball over Wooster, being the rebound.
That is not a bad shot.
Anthony under the basket, the lefty, way short, out of bounds to Utah State when we return.
David Roddy is 6'5", and he weighs 250 pounds. Kato is 7'1". He blocks it. He got part of his arm as well. No count.
Young fans enjoying the game tonight here in Logan. And their team up by 13 on Colorado State. Tomorrow night, starting at 6 Eastern, back on the hardwood. More college hoops action. VCU takes on the Bonnies. An A-10 clash. Catch it all here on CBS Sports Network.
And Bones Highland is the leading scorer for VCU. And I love this guy. He's averaging 18 points a game. He's made more threes than anybody in the league. But Bonnies beat Richmond already. And Bonnies is a team, even though they've been on pause for a while, they haven't played as many games as everybody else. They are a very, very experienced group. And Mark Schmidt's done a wonderful job with them. So that is going to be a good game. VCU, I think, has the surprise team in the A-10. They've won 10 games already.
UMass and the Bonnies atop the A-10 for now. 4-1 records in league play. Inbounds play again works so well for Justin Bean at Utah State. They have taken advantage of inbounds plays successfully tonight several times.
Well, you do football, so you know about offense, defense, special situations, and special teams. And that's what it is in basketball. You know, free throw line, getting an offensive rebound, inbound passes. Notice it was a bounce pass, so the guy guarding the inbounder couldn't get his hands on it. Very good fundamentals. Kato wants it. Moore has forced him off of the lane. Look how far out he's catching the ball here. Nice job by Moore.
Kato, look at the one-handed bounce pass. But Wooster can't find the handle. It's a turnover. Roddy finds a loose chain. Stevens on the bounce for Moore. It's broken up. As we talked about yesterday, we had a nice Zoom chat with Justin Bean. And pregame over this win streak, he's giving out an MJ quote. Have to expect things of yourself before you can do them. Believe in yourself. Good things will happen. He watched The Last Dance, as many of us did, during the early months of the pandemic over the summer streaming that. It was fantastic. And gosh, just realize how dominant Michael Jordan was. Well, remember that, but what a series. Incredible to watch. And Justin taking advantage of that with a MJ quote. It's pretty cool. Foul call here. While the win streak is going, Bob, you got to keep the quotes coming, right? I mean, he's got to dig in for more Michael Jordan stuff. And try to win their 11th straight game here tonight. I assume with Bean yesterday. Thistle Woods got one more free throw.
Thomas is in at center right now. Moores is out. And Nico Medved doing a good job rotating the two of them in and out of the game. Tanji in the game right now, also number one for Colorado State, has not done much in this game and had his fame when he made that four-point play against San Diego State. So defense now for Colorado State has to be very, very intense. And right there, very good job by Thomas on the block shot, but the length of Kata is just dominant.
Three fouls on the Sean Thomas of Colorado State, coach.
Let's take a look at this. Pick, roll, throw it up high, and you notice how he keeps the ball up, does not bring it down. It's fouled on the arm. So he's going to get to the free throw line plenty, and that's one part of his game that's not very good, just 55% from there. And that's something that he'll need to improve as the season wears on.
Namias Kata, coach, one of three players in the last 25 years. Check these numbers out. To average 11 points, 8.5 rebounds, 3.5 assists, 2.5 blocks a game. One other guy on that list, Tim Duncan.
That's wow. Good company.
Good company.
The Wake Forest star. Got a few rings with the San Antonio Spurs.
Sure did. Thomas up top. Thistle Wood.
Look how low Kata gets when he's getting ready to play defense on that roll man.
Tanjay kicks for Stevens. Nine to shoot. On the bounce, Tanjay. Look who's going to block the shot right on cue. Kata, another rejection. He's got three blocks in the game tonight. Wooster to the basket. Foul call on Thistle Wood.
Kata was everywhere on that defensive possession. Hedging out front, dropping back, helping on one side, going to the other side and blocking the shot. I mean, notice how he waits until the offensive player jumps. If you're a good shot blocker, you should never jump before the offense. The defense always jumps second.
165 career blocks now, number one all time in Utah State history. Against New Mexico earlier this year, broke Gilbert Pete's record of 155. Set between 1986 and 89. He can do it all for Utah State. What a talent. Overplay. Ashworth, but can't finish. Surprising miss.
Bean got hit in the face. Bean, number 24, under the basket, was holding his nose right there. His eyes could be watering when you get hit in the nose. That happens.
Stevens needs help. Tanjay thinking three ball. Battles out. Another rebound for Kata. That's eight.
You know, Kata gets rebounds out of his area as well, not just the ones that come off near him. I mean, he uses his length really well.
Ashworth for Bean. From a miss on a baseline shot.
The transition game of Colorado State, which is a weapon that they use very, very effectively, has not been there much in this game.
More corner three ball. Can't find the range, can't click. Ashworth is running. Passes to Wooster, who's fouled by Thistlewood again.
Well, two freshman guards running the break together there. Look pretty, pretty impressive. On the move. Look one way, pass the other. He kind of lost the handle there a little bit. I'm not sure Thistlewood really fouled him. He went straight up. I think Wooster just lost the basketball.
Craig Smith told us yesterday, Raleigh Wooster is like Jerome Bettis.
Like
and
Jerome
Steven
Bettis?
Ashworth is like Darren Sproles. He just did the football analogy for us. If you talk with Craig Smith on a Zoom, as we did yesterday, one question can be a 30-minute answer. Talk about charismatic, interesting, intelligent, and engaging. I mean, it's an entertaining Zoom meeting, to say the least. wide variety of topics with the third year head coach here in Logan, has won two straight Mountain West tourney championships.
I love his enthusiasm.
Man, he's great.
Yeah, and he's tough on his guys, and he's insistent on what they should do. But I'll tell you what, I would like to play for him because he gives you freedom on offense. You better play D, but on the offensive end, he gives freedom to the players. They are not looking over at the bench to see if that was a good shot or not. They just play with decisiveness at the offensive end.
Dave Ryan, Bob Wentzel with you, watching this Mountain West showdown and a 15-point Utah State lead. A bucket a moment ago from Stevens. Anthony to fake. Nice spin move for the lefty, but can't finish.
Here's opportunity knocking.
Stevens transition three. Too strong. Kate another rebound. He's got nine in the game. One more for a double-double. And a foul call over the back.
You got to let that go. Come on. I mean, Roddy was going in there trying to get the offensive rebound. Picks up a cheap one right there. You know, the reason that Utah State is ahead by this many points is I know they look good on offense, and I know Kata does an awful lot, but their defense on Stevens and Roddy has been so, so good in this game, and that's the reason that they have this big, big cushion.
Anthony bumped by Tanjay on the baseline.
Again, because of the Mountain West setup with back-to-back games, they're going to wait a day, not wait, but there'll be a day in between, and they will play again 2 days from now. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of different, and this is true of all of the games that are played in this league, what kind of adjustments are made.
Ashworth, Kato gathers, lays it in, and one. Nameesh Kata, a spectacular game again tonight for Utah State.
Ashworth makes a beautiful pass right here. Ball fakes, drives, and he wanted to lob it for the dunk, but Kata just caught it and went up softly and makes the free throw, which is very, very encouraging. Like to see him get better in that area of the game.
6 of 9 tonight, Bob, from the line. 18 points, 9 rebounds for Kata.
Pretty good. 6 of 9. Yeah, pretty good for him.
That's not bad at all. 4 fouls on Thomas, by the way, of Colorado State. Stevens for 2.
Stevens has put his head under the basket and tried to come out either side with single screens, and it has not been easy. Nameesh Kata is a good player. Number 23 in white takes it in strong. 61-45 for the home team. You're watching college basketball on
Utah State swept the Rams last year in 2 games in the regular season, up big here. But Colorado State knows a thing or two about comebacks. Largest ever Mountain West history at Viejas against the Aztecs early this year on January 2nd. Let's flash back. Rams down 3 with 12.3 seconds left. They came all the way back from down 26. John Tanjay in the corner. Hits the shot, fouled by Jordan Shackle. Yes, it's a 4-point play for Tanjay, who had just arrived in time for the game and attended his dad's wedding in Southern California. And he said afterwards, "That was my wedding gift to my father." Completing the 4-point play, the 3-point shot, plus 1 on the foul by Shackle to beat San Diego State and create some history for CSU in Mountain West play. Pretty cool. Can they do it again? I don't know. That might be tough against this Utah State team, Bob. Aggies playing great basketball right now.
Well, Colorado State has won some close games, and of course that was the biggest that we just described, but they've won some close games aside from that game, not with as big comebacks, obviously. So they've been making good plays down the stretch in games. But in this game, I mean, I'm not feeling it. And, you know, I just think offensively they've been struggling big time. They're not getting any easy baskets.
11th miscue of the game for the Rams there. Roddy with a pass and cut to the hoop, but he lost it off his leg out of bounds. A free throw line jumper. Alfonso Anderson, the senior forward, out of Tacoma, Washington, has his first 2 and a smile.
I think that's his first shot of the game, too. He played in the first half.
Yep. Roddy up top. Tanjay way short. And yes, you're hearing the airball chant at the Spectrum here in Logan. Some fans are here, finally. Anderson to take, had that one blocked. K-Dub, the offensive rebound for another double-double. Offensive foul this time. That is just his second foul of the game. 18 points, 11 rebounds, Bob, tonight for Namiash Keita, 21st career double-double.
On the move, Stevens got there. He was outside of the restricted arc. He was facing Keita. It's a good play defensively by Stevens right there.
A foot shorter at 6 foot compared to Keita's 7 feet tall. That was impressive. Gutsy. Off ball, legal screen called Colorado State.
All right there, that's moving for sure, and that's not allowed. One of the points of emphasis actually this year, and J.D. Collins, the national coordinator of officials for the NCAA, does a call that explains some of the points of emphasis this year, and that was one of the moving screens, especially since so many teams are running on-ball screens. Whoa, how's that about a battle? What are you doing, man?
Too much dribbling for the seven-footer. Almost turns it over, tie up, and Utah State does keep the ball here. That was a little too much for Namiash Keita. I think Craig Smith realizes that.
Oh, I'm telling you. You know, and that's part of what we've talked about, that he does turn the ball over some, and, you know, trying to dribble a little too much.
Turnover, a five-second call. Now, Namiash Keita did not go home to Portugal during the early stages of the pandemic, Bob, as you mentioned earlier in the broadcast. Coach Smith happy. He was so concerned, he and his staff, that Namiash couldn't get back in the United States if he did.
Yeah, very interesting, right? You know, and that happens with a lot of teams. Nice cut right there. Beautiful play by Thistlewood. Clear the area of the basket. Get five guys outside the three-point line and cut or drive it.
Thistlewood and Stevens, a double figures for Colorado State. Each 11 to lead the way for the Rams tonight. Ashworth passing. Wooster, good feed. Marco Anthony up for two, the and one for Utah State.
Boy, I'll tell you what, they can pass the ball and they look for one another. Great teamwork by Utah State. The drive along the baseline, the help comes, and Anthony just cuts to the basket, and Wooster gives him a great, great pass. That is beautiful basketball. And nice hands by Anthony, too. That was not an easy catch.
Two players all year, as we talked about, for Utah State, 20-plus points in a game. That's it. Marco Anthony at 22 against Northern Iowa early in the year, and being at 21 against the College of Idaho, a non-Division I team. That is it for the entire season.
Well, what they do is, the explanation is that they share the ball. Obviously, they're a team of well-balanced guys. And they play eight players in every game. So, you know, one guy's not going to play 35 minutes and get a ton of shots. The shots come equally.
Roddy, good hustle, offensive glass. He is fouled. Anderson, I think, made the contact before Keita did.
I believe you're right.
First personal foul on Alfonso Anderson, the senior and transfer from North Idaho College. Outstanding student athlete. Roddy, a great player, but not his night so far. 0 for 4 from the field, Bob. Just now 4 points off from the free throw line.
Well, he's a take-it-to-the-basket guy, and when you have a rim protector like Keita in there, it's not going to get, you're going to be in traffic all the time, and he's given up a ton of length against Keita. And Keita makes sure that he's close to the basket 90% of the time.
Miller the rebound. Got a big first half with four threes. Looking for his first of the second half. Right on cue. Thanks, Brock. I mean, he scripted it for me, Bob. Five threes tonight.
He's got a quick trigger, there's no doubt about that, and he's a very experienced player.
Foul call on Marco Anthony.
Yeah, he's got his hands all over Bird. Check out Brock Miller. Catch, shoot. He gets that ball to the shooting pocket very, very quickly. The pass was to his left, and he got it to his right very, very fast.
Brother Corbin played. Brother Brandon played college basketball. Brandon played in Utah. His dad Brett played at BYU Hawaii. Great hoop tradition in the Miller family. Here's Bird. A back iron miss. It's out of bounds.
Here's a stat that underlies the point of Brock Miller being a three-point shooter. 73 of his 107 shots this year coming into this game are from three-point range. So 70% of his shots attempts are coming from beyond the arc, and that is his role on this team.
Five Aggie players to serve an LDS mission. He went to Argentina for 2 years. Ashworth served as well. He'll come back 2 years older, but you can't play a lot of basketball and work out during your mission. It's about serving the church. Traveling call. And a timeout. Eight even to go. Second half from the Spectrum in Logan, Utah. It's all Aggies all the time tonight in the Mountain West on CBS Sports Network. Well, tonight, the Mish Canup spectacular, Bob, as we check the Geico Difference Makers. No surprise, he's represented Utah State tonight.
18 points on 6 of 8, 11 rebounds, 3 blocks. Just another day at the office for Nemeas Keita. And on the other side of things, the Geico difference maker is Isaiah Stevens. And, of course, for him, 11 points is below his average, 5 for 11. So even though he has been guarded beautifully and hasn't made as much of an impact as he normally does, he's still doing a good job for his team.
Averages 15 a game, just behind Roddy. Second on the Rams in scoring entering play tonight. Does have 4 assists, entered this one with 75 helpers, tops in the Mountain West. But the stars for the Rams have not been big factors.
Well, you're playing an away game against a team that has won 10 straight games, who's feeling extremely confident. You've won 4 straight games, but still it's an away game and there's a backcourt violation. I have been very, very impressed with Utah State's defense, and Nico Medved is a very good offensive coach, knows how to get his guys shots. He's tried lots of different things in this game, but the impact of Keita in terms of taking away the lane and taking away those kind of things, and the impact of Anthony guarding on the perimeter has been really very, very sound.
Wooster on the bounce for Ashworth.
Extra pass, right
guy. Almost rattles out. Anderson, a hand of the offensive glass, comes to Stevens. Trying to lead Morris, but it's not even close. And the 14th Ram turnover of the night.
I was watching Keita run back there on defense, and his agility for a guy 7 feet is very, very good. I mean, he runs straight ahead and then turns sideways, gets his hands up in the air, and does like defensive slides all the way in. I mean, he really, I mean, just watch his footwork here on offense, too. Look how wide he gets when he wants the basketball. Shows his hand for the passer. I mean, talk about a guy who's a fundamentally sound person.
8-3 of the year for Alfonso Anderson. Everyone getting into the act here in this huge lead for Utah State. I'm with you. Great feat. Fun to watch and prepare for Keita. Seeing him on tape. He grew up in Portugal, so I'm sure he played soccer growing up, right? I mean, that's the first sport there for sure. Moore's the miss. Could help explain the footwork, which is so good for Keita. He is quick. Miller, the movement, trying to hit Keita on the bounce, foul first. Yet another double-double for Keita tonight. 18 points and 12 rebounds. 21 in his career. He's tied Justin Bean. Last year, led the Aggies with double-doubles, had 16 of them. That was the most since Bob Larisky had 16 back in 1971-72. Really good 1-2 punch with Bean and Cato.
Well, Bean has been an outstanding rebounder his entire career. And Bean, of course, at one juncture was a walk-on and earned a scholarship and has been a starter ever since. So the combination of those two guys inside is really, really good. And Bean plays all over the floor. He's not a great three-point shooter. He moves great without the ball. That's his biggest asset that he brings to the team. And his rebounding is stellar.
17 in the game for Miller tonight. Justin Bean from Moore, Oklahoma, told us yesterday in our Zoom call, I was in Reno, Nevada, finishing out my LDS mission, and Utah State asked me over a Subway sandwich with assistant coach to walk on. He was thrilled because that was his best offer, and has become a huge star in the Mountain West. Roddy muscles his way to the basket for two.
Ashworth getting a lot of time in this game, being rewarded for how well he played in the last game.
Miller again for three.
Wow.
Six triples tonight for Brock Miller. Goodness. His career high against Denver last year was 7 threes. He's about to smash that tonight.
Little hold right here by Brock Miller, but at the offensive end, he is a threat. He gets his wrist underneath the ball, snaps his wrist, holds his follow through. Very sound fundamentals. He works at it.
Two-time All-Academic Mountain West as well. Brock Miller, great student athlete, business administration major. Stevens the take for two. He's got 13 tonight to lead the Rams. But it's been a quiet 13. The Aggies leading the Mountain West in scoring margin. They've been blasting teams 16 points a game. Question. Colorado State here tonight in Logan. Anthony, a lot of contacts. Thistlewood has got four fouls. And it goes to the Rams.
So he took a charge, and earlier in the year, they took seven charges early in a game this season. So they are a position-oriented team. Thistlewood's pretty good at it.
Tom Taylor handling the paint, the take, and can't finish again. Roddy, nice rebound late today. Eight points, eight rebounds for Roddy tonight. That was a double-double threat. 6'5", 250 freight train down low for Colorado State. This guy, something. Anderson can't convert this time. Kendall Moore for Roddy. Thistlewood, nice fake and hits.
No give up by Colorado State. When your record is 10-2, 7-1 in the league, you're used to winning. So they're in territory right now that they have not been in. I know they were getting smashed by San Diego State and came back and won that game. And then in the rematch, San Diego State won. Shackle, who was the guy who fouled Tanji, had a great game in the second game. I think he was a little bit like he had been responsible for the loss and made up for it in the second game.
Another bucket for Utah State and Anderson. Who's played really well in this second half. He's been active. Loose change, lays it in. Wow. He's got 10 points after being invisible offensively in the first half for the Aggies. Everyone getting in on the act. Stevens hits another three. He's got two triples in the game. Nine.
There are five players sitting by the scorer's table waiting to come into the game. Two for Utah State and three for Colorado State. And they are praying a whistle happens so that they get into the game.
No rush here for Stephen Ashworth. Launches a three over Thistlewood. Good hustle from Miller. Extended possession again here for the Aggies. Pop in. Anthony, two to shoot, launches. Not this time. Stephen to rebound. I doubt the Mountain West or the nation needed notice that Utah State is a really good team. This, to me, is a statement game. Roddy, nice take, is fouled, leading us to a break. Alfonso Anderson among many Aggies showing up tonight. Both ends of the court. He's got 10 points on the second half. It's a big lead for Utah State over Colorado State. First the deep shot, then the layup. You're watching college basketball on CBS Sports Network, presented by Ace Hardware. All right, Bob, time now for the play of the game brought to you by Ace, the helpful place.
Who else but Kada? What else? A shot block. Guy is everywhere, defensively, offensively, comes from the weak side to make blocks. Blocks his own man. He is a big-time shot blocker, and that's why he's the all-time shot blocker at Utah State University. And he has had his night, and he is done for the evening.
Well-deserved rest, I'd say. Up to 165 career rejections, tops in Aggie history. All right, you coached the NBA, Bob, for a while. Give us your evaluation. Lottery pick? How high?
No. I don't think he's a lottery pick, but okay. I mean, it just depends on what teams need. And obviously, 18, 12, and 3 in this game, you know. But, you know, he's got ways to go, but certainly he's going to have a long career in the NBA. And the way he puts strength on is very, very important, because when he went to the combine 2 years ago, he got pushed around and really was thin and not as well educated in the game as he is now. And I think his passing ability, guys on NBA teams will love him because he'll be passing them the ball. So he's gonna be in the draft, and he's gonna have a good career. I don't think there's any doubt about that.
Taking a break for now. And done for the night. Foul call at the end. So Anderson to the free throw line. Two free throws here for the Aggies, up by 20.
Anderson had the ball and he was ready to shoot, and he gave it back to the official. Oh man, that's how you see everything.
Take it. You just gotta take those shots. One more here coming up. And coming up next, get you caught up on all your college hoops from around the country, inside college basketball right here on CBS Sports Network. A lot of scores in the AP Top 25 to talk about. Michigan dominant. Win over Maryland. Alabama is pounding LSU on the road in the SEC. And Ohio State, a loss to Purdue, Bob, in the Big Ten.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. Purdue's good. Painter is a excellent, excellent coach.
We had them on the air in the Space Coast Challenge from Melbourne, Florida, way back in November. Played a couple games on our air. Rivera to the game. Pump fake. Short on the jumper front iron. Ninety-second standing between Utah State and the Aggies' 11th straight win. Best start of conference play in 10 years.
Well, it's a great conference. I mean, there's no doubt about that. Right now, Palm has four teams in the NCAA tournament. And whether it will turn out that way at the end of the season, we will see. And, of course, we got news today about the NCAA tournament. It will not start on Tuesday like it typically does after Selection Sunday. It will start on Thursday. And for those of you who don't know, all of the games will be played in Indiana, and most of them in the Indianapolis area. A couple of games are going to be played at Purdue and at IU, which are only about an hour and a half from Indianapolis. Final four at Lucas Oil Stadium.
Foul call with under a minute to go here in regulation tonight. These teams play in 2 days.
Yeah, I was just thinking about that. And Nico Medved, we asked him about that. And he was ambivalent. There were pluses and minuses to it, as most coaches believe. And he will put on his thinking cap and try to adjust and play better the next time. And I think from a physical point of view, you want to get your guys rest. You don't want to work them too hard the day between these two games, especially in a game like this where they got beat up pretty good. It wasn't for lack of effort at all. I mean, Utah State was just a buzzsaw in this game.
Max Shulga is in the game for the first time for Utah State from Kiev, Ukraine.
Some guys ready to get in on the bench, but it may not happen. A foul would be good. Stops the clock. Gets them into the game.
Anderson spins. Way short. Air ball. Track down. Tanjay. Shot clock violation.
Well, those guys will get in.
Yeah, 20.2 seconds. Come on. Get them in the lineup a little bit. 1,600 plus enjoying this one. Another win at the Spectrum. It'll be their 21st in the last 23 games on their home court. Dominant tonight.
I have done plenty of games, and you have too, at Utah State, and it is a beautiful drive from Salt Lake City when you go through that pass and get into the Cache Valley, and they usually are sold out and very, very loud.
Oh! Bird the steal off the Thomas make with less than 10 seconds to go in the second half. Coach Smith told us via Zoom yesterday he loves their connectivity, as he described it, among many topics of conversation. He thinks this team's self-awareness, their ability to dig in defensively, share the ball. Obviously, a player of the year candidate in Cata.
But what they're going to have to do is they're going to have to beat Boise State. And Boise State is very, very good. Alston is a 6'9", do-it-everything player all over the floor. They pass it well. They shoot it well. They remind me, actually, of Utah State. So that is going to be very, very big. And they've already proven, you know, they swept San Diego State. So Boise State is the next challenge after this next game against Colorado State.
Make it 11 straight. The longest of what has been a very successful run for Craig Smith leading this Utah State program. Already won two Mountain West Tournament championships in now his third year. He's 66-18 as the head coach and now 36-9 in the Mountain West. Wow. A dominant run. 83-64 the final in the first of a two-game series head-to-head with the Rams. So now Boise State and Utah State, each undefeated. And you're right, collision course down the road with those two teams going head-to-head will be fun to watch. This was all Aggies tonight. Cata was fantastic. Easy win for Utah State. More on the way from Logan.